It was one to remember at the Wells Fargo Center on Thursday night as the Flyers had their best first period in about 5.5 years. 5 goals and a 5-0 lead at the first intermission turned into a 6-3 win over the New York Islanders. The Flyers started things up 4.5 minutes into the first period, the first of 3 goals involving the line of Sean Couturier, Braden Schenn, and Dale Weiss. And on this one, Weiss was able to put a nifty move on a pass from Couturier that was actually deflected. Weiss is able to lift it right into the top of the net for his 6th goal of the year, giving the Flyers the 1-0 advantage. A minute 19 later, they doubled the score. Brandon Manning with the initial shot here on this rush. Thomas Greiss makes the save, but the rebound goes right to Sean Couturier, who puts it home for his 13th of the year. Braden Schenn assisted on both of those first 2 goals, and the Flyers led 2-0. They made it 3-0 just about 2.5 minutes later. Again, the line of Weiss, Couturier, and Schenn on the ice, but this time it was Radko Gudas getting it done with the blast from the right point through traffic. It beats Greiss. It was challenged for goaltender interference, but it was not upheld. Flyers led 3-0, 8:06 into this game. Sean Couturier with a point on each of those first 3 goals, and it spelled a very early end to the night of Thomas Greiss, who was pulled at that point in favor of Yaroslav Halak. Flyers did not stop there, though. A minute 13 later, they add to the advantage. Jordan Wheel continuing his red-hot play, his 7th goal in 15 games with the Flyers this year. Wayne Simmonds and Valtteri Filppula get the assist on the Wheel bid at 9:19 of the first period, so the Flyers led this one 4-0 before the game was even 10 minutes old. They added one more on the second half of the first period on the power play. Shane Gostisbehere with this blast. It hits Wayne Simmonds right on the kneecap. A fortuitous bounce goes off an Islanders defender and in for Simmonds' 30th goal of the season, 16th power play goal of the year. He was able to shake this one off as it definitely stung, but it gave the Flyers the 5-0 advantage at the first intermission. Islanders started crawling back from that point. They got 1 goal about 3 minutes into the second period. Cal Clutterbuck picking up his 4th of the year to start the scoring for the Islanders from Steven Gionta and Calvin DeHaan. This was the start of a monster second period for the Islanders, who outshot the Flyers 22-3 in that second period. But Steve Mason stood tall, did not allow anything other than that 1 goal in the second period, and able to get the Flyers to the intermission. The Islanders did add 2 more in the third, but Valtteri Filppula with an empty netter late in the third was able to ice it for the Flyers and get to the eventual 6-3 win. Around the locker room after the game, the Flyers obviously were very happy with the first period, not so much so with the second 2 periods, saying they really needed to buckle down a little bit better and hold the Islanders at bay, but obviously happy with the outcome overall tonight.
No, you never think you'd score 5 goals in a period, but I think we did the right things. We played well. I wish we played that way the second period. I think the second period was, a down period for us, but first was great.
The second?
Yeah.
Well, we had to reset after the second there. I mean, it's really hard when you come out in an emotional game like that. We come out early, a couple fights, we get a start like that. It's really hard to kind of ramp up the intensity after that. We knew they were going to come in a push. They're a prideful hockey team over there. So we just had to kind of reset and find a way to come out and play 20 hard and close out the game.
I think everybody understood that, we needed a better second period. We can't have a first period like that and come out like that in the second. So, at the end of the day, we know we needed a better second, but we got the 2 points.
Yeah, it's special, and the Flyers fan enjoy that. And it was the first period was exactly how we wanted to play, and we had a huge lead there. And Kutz's line did a lot of good things tonight, and they were dominant tonight.
So the Flyers have one more left on this 3-game homestand. They will go into Saturday with a 3-game winning streak as they welcome in the New Jersey Devils to the Wells Fargo Center for a 7 p.m. puck drop. But it's a big win tonight over the New York Islanders, 6-3 here at the Wells Fargo Center.